Oh, hey there! I'm Bob Ross, I mean Roman Papush, and I would like to welcome you to the Joy of Shading series. Today we're gonna create this lovely procedural road using only Unity's Shader Graph. Despite the seeming complexity, this tutorial is completely accessible even if you have never been touched by shaders before. But before we jump straight in, allow me to express my gratitude to this video's sponsor, the all-awesome Skillshare. Is an incredibly affordable online learning community with easily digestible courses on just about everything. Being a solo developer means I have to constantly change hats and learn new things. That's why I'm proudly partnering with Skillshare, because you'll be hard-pressed to find a topic not yet covered on the platform, including a ton of Unity 3D and general game design courses to complement what you'll learn here today. And here's the best part. First 500 to click the link in the description will get 2 free months of premium membership. Life throwing curveballs all the time. I know, I've been there. Heck, this is my first video of the year. But let me tell you, it's not too late to make 2020 a year to finally move forward with that passion of yours. Treat yourself, my dudes. There's one limited free membership with your name on it in the description below. So I tell you what, let's get started. With our shader graph open and basically any lit master node ready, we begin by creating a couple happy rectangle nodes. They will become our edge lines. Every safe road should have those. By the way, what I have in my scene right now is just a box created using ProBuilder, with any UVs except for the top part removed, so that I won't have my texture repeated on all of the sides. But you do you, you can just drop a Unity cube and be done with it. To control the position of our lines independently, we are adding the tiling and offset node to each of our rectangles. Pay attention to the values I put into the fields during the time-lapse, if you want to follow this along exactly. By creating a single vector and outputting it through negate node, basically creating a mirrored copy, we are able to easily control the offsets of our lines with just one variable. Convert it to property and you'll see it show up in the inspector after saving. For now, let's group the nodes we created so far, call them outer lines and position them with style. Remember to save your shader periodically, so you can see the changes applied in the scene. That is exactly what we can do right now, by controlling the only exposed field so far. What I'm gonna do next is create another exposed field, so that I will be able to control the width of the lines as well. Let's have some more shader fun. This is your world, and in your world you can do any old thing you... I gotta stop trying with these terrible Bob Ross impressions. But seriously, what I want to do is to create a copy of my nodes, and by replacing the very first node with a new one, I'm able to create a couple more happy inner lines. Just smack dab them in together, and not even 2 minutes into the tutorial, the results are already looking pretty fine. Let's add some color. Our lines deserve some expression. Maybe a little yellow, it doesn't matter. What the heck, be bold. This is also a good time to mention that no, that is not your YouTube stuttering, but my footage, which will have hiccups anytime changes are made inside of Unity. Once again, I'm duplicating all the nodes within the last group we created. And what's coming next is crucial and no less interesting. The fraction node allows us to repeat and loop our texture, which means we are getting to the fun part of creating dashed lines. And because we have two axes to work with, this will also allow us to generate as much lines as we desire, making the shader pretty flexible. To make the fraction lines now appear mirrored on each side of the inner yellow lines, I modify one of the tiling and offset nodes with the rotate node, making sure to set the unit to degrees and entering a value of 180. Next, we finally create a property to control the ratio of line length to empty space in between. As you can see, our dashed lines are starting to take shape. But before we make any further changes, I'm taking some time to create masks for them. You see, right now both of our dashed lines nodes show left and right side, which is not what we desire. So by means of creating a couple more rectangle nodes, we mask them through the basic multiply node. All's left is to create a couple of properties to control the amount of dashes and the number of lines we want to appear on each side of the road. Looking good, but notice how dashed lines are rendered much thinner than the other ones. That happens because the more lines we have, the more the texture is squished, but luckily that is countered easily by multiplying line width parameter with the dashed lines count. And now we're in business. Guys, dudes, my mateys. Before the final step to tie it all up together, let me show you a sneak peek of what I'm working on right now. It is a 3D puzzle action title, which is basically Portal with explosions. You would do me a huge favor by wishlisting the game on Steam, if that is your jam. And be sure to subscribe for more tutorials, devlogs and gamedev videos. Okay, back to delicious stuff. What I'm doing here is simply creating another mega mask by only using rectangle nodes and the properties we already defined. We will use it on our dashed lines, so that they would always stay inside the borders of our outer and inner lines and never cross over. It's nothing complex, just takes a few nodes to pull off. If we now go back to our scene, we will be able to control any parameter and our road will respond flawlessly. By the way, those clouds behind the road are also made 100% with Shader Graph. And if you want to learn how to make them, I have an extensive in-depth tutorial on that. Just follow the link in the description. And if you're not feeling like repeating the tutorial, or just want to fiddle with the end result, you can do so by supporting me on Patreon. Any tier will grant you access to all of the files for both the road and the cloud shaders. All the links are in the description. Finally, bring a smile to my face by wishlisting my ridiculous game, go get yourself free limited Skillshare membership, comment your life story, don't be a d**k and keep on being awesome!